Hi, welcome to Crossfire. My name is Josh Greenwald, and I'm with the New Hampshire Association of Realtors. And I'm here with Michael Wilford with the Red Door Title and Bennett Law Firm. And we are here to discuss the dark web, which Michael was gracious enough to inform us all about. Welcome, Michael.
Thank you.
How you doing?
I'm great.
All right, great. Hey, so I have a question. The dark web, all right. Are we at risk
as realtors? I mean, we find that a lot of nefarious actors tend to make their business on the dark web. So a lot of spyware and a lot of ransomware services that are used to target specific campaigns against legitimate businesses often start and proliferate on the dark web. Mm-hmm. Most specifically, I've found that spyware originating on the dark web or sold or bartered on the dark web can find its way onto computers of realtors and other people in the real estate industry. And more frequently, we see that exporting their contact lists and their emails, not necessarily taking over their email accounts because of the very nature of spyware is kind of run undetected. But what it does is it transfers all of that information off to a third party, and they then spoof the agent and end up launching email campaigns in order to take advantage of their clients.
So it could become a real risk for realtors because we have a lot of contacts, we have a lot of their files, so we're kind of responsible for protecting our clients' privacy.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
All right, so what can we do as realtors in the Realtor Association to protect ourselves at home and in our office?
I maintain that 90% of your own safety is going to be common sense. Making sure that you understand that these things exist and that they're out there. Making sure that you're not putting yourself in any positions where you may potentially be compromised. Don't visit any websites that don't seem on the up and up. Don't respond to any suspicious emails. The other 10% of your safety is really just software like antivirus. Mm-hmm. If you don't have antivirus software on your computer, you absolutely want that, and you do absolutely want to pay for it. Spam filtering for your email, etc.
When they say, please update your computer, you should say, okay, not update me later.
Yeah, Windows updates are absolutely critical. I know they always come at the worst time. It's when you're sitting down at the closing table or you're meeting with a client, and guess what? Windows updates are applying, and they're only at 6%. But they do so much more than just apply cosmetic and aesthetic changes to your computer. They patch security holes and fill vulnerabilities that are known to be exploited.
That makes a lot of sense. Thank you so much for coming today.
Thank you.
All right.